your ruler.
Salt.
Your lands, your possessions, your very lives will gladly be given in tribute to me.
What's up, guys? So this is going to be my The Flash Season 1 and Season 2 review of The Flash television show. So, as far as Flash content, before this show came out in 2014, I'm only recently, like, getting into it, because back then, I went over this heavily in the Arrow Season 1 through 3 review, but I just couldn't get into it because of certain aspects of it that I've gotten over now. So, I'm not going to dive into that and sidetrack the video, because I could sidetrack and completely derail the video. But anyways, before this show came out, I was familiar with The Flash from the 1990s television show. He had his own, it was only one season, but live action television show. Yeah, I was also familiar with him from Superman, because he made a lot of, obviously, Justice League, Justice Friends, like all old school 80s stuff. But he was also in the Superman the Animated Series. He was in Justice League, Justice League Unlimited. You know, I was never bought comics as kids, as a kid, but like occasionally I would, you know, occasionally if I was in a store or something, you know, I would browse, and I would go to the section where they had the comics wrapped up, and I would look at the pretty pictures, you know, because they had them sealed up, so you couldn't read them. I mean, some comic store you could open them up and read them, but without buying them. But most of the time, if it was on a rack in a store, it wasn't even a comic book store, but it'd be like just some random store in the mall that also sells comics. And they'd be sealed up, so you couldn't read them. But anyways. And also, another really good Flash movie that I liked was the DC animated film that came out. I think it came out 2011 or 12. Came out a couple years before this 2014 show came out. It was the Flashpoint Paradox. Right, in the Flashpoint Paradox, it was such a good film. All of the DC animated films are so good, but it really made me start to appreciate and like Reverse Flash. And on that note, Season 1 of The Flash, I think one of its strongest, most shows don't have a strong season one. A lot of shows don't have a strong season one. And a lot of times, if a show does have a strong season one, it's only downhill after that. In my opinion, Reverse Flash not only makes The Flash season one just epic from the jump, right? Like, just epic from the jump. You can see him right there in the poster. The yellow guy, right? But the build up with the audience, like, the build up with the audience is like, it puts him on the same level as like the Joker is to Batman. Like, because it's like the kind of thing where the audience knows, the audience sees, right? But all the other characters don't know. And so, like, from the very first scene where Harrison Wells stands up out of his chair while he's alone, and you're like, what the hell? Right? And then you see that he's got the red lightning. You know, because you see in the poster right there, Reverse Flash has red lightning, and The Flash has gold lightning, right? So, and it's also significant that in season one, the Flash has a red and yellow lightning bolt emblem, right? A red and yellow lightning bolt emblem. And Reverse Flash has a black and red lightning bolt emblem. You can't see it right there because it's a little bit motion blurred, but anyway, so you see him get up, right, out of his wheelchair the first time, and then other times you see him use the red lightning. You see him use his speed when he's not in the suit. So the entire season, you know somehow that he's the Reverse Flash, but we don't know any of the details behind it. Right? And as they slowly start to trickle the details of the whole thing and like what's really going on, you're like, holy shit, this is epic. This is epic. And as also, I feel like this is the first TV show after, since like Smallville for the time, because this came out in 2014, right? And the only show that pushed special effects this hard was small, like before this was Smallville, and this show is like damn near movie quality. There's some sequences that you feel like you're watching a movie. You feel like you're watching an action sequence straight out of a movie. Like for a 2014 show, it not only does it hold up to today, but a lot of shows don't even have the quality, the movie sequences that this show has even today. They don't have it. It's really good. It's like really, like there's some sequences where like you'll be watching an episode and like, man, this episode is kind of like, I, you know, I'm enjoying it because like I'm chilling, but the episode's kind of blah blah blah, you know, so and so is doing this and blah 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 and whatever, and then all of a sudden an action sequence comes out of the blue, and you know, like a chase sequence or a save sequence or like some sort of whatever action, and you're like, holy shit, this whole episode was worth it just for that. Like but anyways, so Harrison Wells turns out to be his mentor and also the Reverse Flash. But then it turns out that, I mean, there's so many, I don't want to give away the whole thing, but dang, dude, it's crazy. It's crazy how good the show is. Like, and as soon as you think, oh, it couldn't get any better, like, oh, they can't top that special effects sequence, you know, that, no way. Like, and then he does, and then he learns some new way to apply his ability, and then he learns something else, and then every single time you see Reverse Flash, I mean, dude, in my opinion, Reverse Flash is cooler looking than the Flash, like undeniable. Look at that costume, look at that red and yellow, that's awesome. But anyways, and there's so many other things I want to get into about season one, but this video is going to go on and on and on and on and on. But there's just one thing I want to show, and it is a spoiler of why Reverse Flash is so freaking cool. And dang, dude, it's crazy. It's like the villain is, it's such a paradox, dude. I don't want to get into it, but it's such a Terminator 2 style paradox of a season. And it's like, anyway, so let's jump. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna show you this. This is my favorite scene from season one, and season one is so good, I don't want to like give away every single detail about it, but it's like, I thought it was amazing. I thought everything from start to finish to the season finale to all the choices that had to be made, and I thought everything start to finish was awesome. And then I'll move on to season two, And I just want to show this one season or this one scene from season one. So hold on. Let me. Let me bring this up. Okay. So, this scene is when I realized, holy shit, Reverse Flash is an amazing, amazing villain. And so I'm gonna play this scene. Why is it not playing? There we go.
Understand. This doesn't make any sense.
My goals are beyond your understanding.
Some would say I'm the reverse. You're incredibly clever, Cisco. I've always said so.
You're him. The Reverse Flash.
You and I have never been truly properly introduced.
I am Eobard Thawne.
Thawne. Like Eddie.
Let's call him a distant relative.
The night that we trapped the Reverse Flash, who almost died. There were two of you.
It's an afterimage, a speed mirage. If you will.
Joe was right. You were there that night, 15 years ago, in Barry's house. You killed Nora Allen.
It was never my intention to kill Nora. I was there to kill Barry.
Why? You're his friend. You've been teaching him how to
go faster. I know. A means to an end. And I'll tell you why. Because I have been stuck here, marooned here in this place for 15 long years. And the Flash, and the Flash's speed is the key to my returning to my world. And no one is going to prevent that from happening.
I can help you.
You're smart, Cisco. But you're not that smart. Do you know how hard it has been to keep all of this from you, especially from you? Because the truth is, I've grown quite fond of you. And in many ways, you have shown me what it's like to have a son. Forgive me, but to me, you've been dead for centuries.
Thank you.
that
there are two of you.
That is why dude, that scene is epic. That scene is epic, and if his costume isn't cool enough, it's like, man, not only is he badass, he's got a fly outfit, and he delivers epic villainous speeches and makes you actually, like, moved. Anyways, that was what sealed the deal. Was like, I was like, holy shit, Reverse Flash is on, like, the level of Joker or Siler or, you know, freaking other villains, epic villains from other franchises. But anyways, I'm going to move on to season 2 of The Flash. So let's discuss season 2. Let me just change this poster real quick. Okay, oh, this is too big. Move this, fix it. There we go. Alright, Flash season 2. So after the events of the end of season 1 with Reverse Flash, those events create an event that allows a being from another multiverse, another Earth, who's also a speedster, to see the Flash and want to come there and, you know, mess up his world and steal his speed, right? And this person is called Zoom, right? Now, allegedly, and I'm not familiar enough with the comics, but allegedly in the comics, Zoom and Reverse Flash are the same person, right? But in the show, they're two different people, and that's okay. The show can do their own thing. But I will say that it felt like they knew they had a... It felt like the show writers knew they did a fantastic job with Reverse Flash in season 1, and they wanted to capture some of that, like, Nemesis, Speedster type stuff, and so they're like, oh, well, let's just make a meaner, scarier, monsterier version of Reverse Flash. And that's, and I mean, it worked, but Zoom is still good, and season 2 is still good. There's a lot of other things to be liked about season 2. But I just feel like the whole time, it's like, yeah, Zoom is cool and all. Like, Zoom is scary and all, but he's no Reverse Flash, right? That's just how I felt. I was like, yeah, okay. Like, yeah, Zoom is bad and Zoom is scary, and but he's no Reverse Flash. But there are some cool things about Zoom. But the problem is, once Zoom finally takes his mask off, it loses some of its mystique. But another specific thing in season 2, they change Flash's logo. So in the first season, it's red and gold, right? The center of it is red, and out and it's gold. And in the season 2, they change it to white in the middle, and then gold, the gold lightning bolt. And that's significant. That's a significant part of the plot. It's significant to the timeline and the time travel. The other thing they introduce in season 2 is they introduce the concept of infinite Earths. There's infinite Earths, and there's infinite multiverses. There's all these other Earths that they can go to where people have doppelgangers, and you lived a different life entirely, different outcomes. And that's really cool. I'm trying not to give spoilers, but they introduce a lot more of Flash's Rogues Gallery in season 2. They also set up Captain Cold. Well, Captain Cold was introduced in season 1, but they continue Captain Cold's story with Heatwave, and they set Captain Cold up to move on and join the Legends of Tomorrow. They also have Firestorm meet his new person and set him up to join the Legends of Tomorrow. They also meet Cisco, meets this girl, and he's like head over heels for her, and she turns out to be Hawk Girl, and she moves on to the Legends of Tomorrow. She leaves him for Hawkman like right away. So it sets up season one of Legends of Tomorrow. Like a lot of things that happen in season two of The Flash and season three of Arrow. Or is it season three of Arrow or season four of Arrow? I think it's season four of Arrow. Set up season one of Legends of Tomorrow. And then the really cool part of season two of The Flash, and this is like even better than season one, and I'm gonna like spoil it completely, but like after he beats Zoom, he's everything's great, he won the day. Everything's not great. He finally got his father out of prison, and Zoom killed his father, so everything's not great, but everything else is great. He beat the villain. He finally has the girl, like the girl that he's wanted to be, have as his girlfriend all these years. She's finally wanting to be his girlfriend. And then he's like, no, fuck all that noise. I'm going back in time to when I was a kid and changing everything. I'm saving my parents and I'm living a different life. Right? I'm living an entirely different life. So he throws literally his entire existence away, and he goes and changes everything. And that's the cliffhanger. Because he had the opportunity to do it at the end of season one, but he didn't. Something told him, this isn't right, I shouldn't do it. Like he saw himself. Like he saw himself in his other self in the timeline, like waved him away, like, don't do it. And now after all of this, all he's been through, and he lost his dad and stuff, he's like, no, I'm gonna do it. And then he does it. That is the end of season two, and it starts season three. And oh boy, it's such a good show. It's like, if you can get past anything that bothers you, like some of the characters suck, like you may not like some of the characters. Other than that, the show's freaking great, dude. The show's freaking great. But anyways, I'm gonna wrap it up because this has already been a really long video. I appreciate you guys for watching this video. If you could please like and subscribe and all of that, and also follow me on Twitch. My name on Twitch is not Rulerzod. My name on Twitch is, I could have swore I already changed that. I could have swore I already changed that text. I thought I did. Well, anyways, my name on Twitch is Rulerzod with a 7. And I'll try and fix that. I'll try and edit that and fix it. But yeah. The link in the description is the correct one. So even though that should be a 7 right there, the link in the description is the correct one. Follow me on Twitch, all that stuff. I appreciate it. And peace out, guys.